First of all, for any web design kind of thing, if I want to go for the web designing, the most important thing is how to design the page, how to design the layout of the page and all. See, the basic for any kind of page layout and all, the two things that we need to follow, one is the table. One is the table that we need to follow, and other than the table, we need to follow the div. Third option is what we can go for the bootstrap. And fourth option is what we can go for. We can go for some website templates and all. Suppose you are going to give me a website to design. What I will do, either I will go for the table or div, or I can use the bootstrap template or bootstrap, or we can use some website templates and all for do that. Suppose my question was, initially my question was how to design the layout like this. Suppose this is my web page. What we need to do, we need to design the layout like this. This will be the header one. This will be the footer. This will be the left portion of the page. And this is the content area we are having. If I need to design this particular website page template, from basics, if I'm going to start with this, what I will do, I will go with the table and then I will go with the div. So through the table, how we can do that? 1, 2, 3. How many rows is there? It's 3 rows is there. 1, 2, and 3. And how many columns is there? 2 columns is there. And remaining having the 1 column. So we are having the 3 row and we are having the 2 column. Remember, always we will consider the column, maximum number of columns. So maximum column is 2. Always we need to consider the row, the number of row, it's 1, 2 and 3. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to design the table. I'm just going to design the table. In the table, what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the width. Width is equal to 100%. I'm going to take the layout, like height is equal to 100%. And I'm going to give the border, border is equal to 1. Now, how many rows is required? It's 2 rows is there, like TR I'm going to use. Okay. For this particular TR, what is the size over there? It's 20%, 20%, 80%, 60%. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to give the size. Height is equal to 20%. And again, I'm going to give the another TR over there. Another TR over there. For this TR, I'm just going to fix the height 60%. And for this, it's 20%. Now, how many column is there? We always need to consider the maximum column. It's 2 column is there. So what I'm going to do in the second one, so I'm just going to use td. Td I'm going to use. And again, I'm going to use the td. So 2 td is there. And for this, I'm going to apply the width is equal to 20%. And here I'm going to give the width is equal to, like width is equal to 80%. 80%, and because we need to hold the blank spaces over there, that's why we are using ampersand NBSP. Here again we are going to use ampersand NBSP. NBSP. This is just for the blank space because it contains the blank spaces over there. So this is how we can define the TD. Now the same thing what we need to do over here, we need to define the TD. But the thing is that this TD width will be the 100%. And because only one TD is there, so what we need to do, we just need to use, because we don't have the multiple TD, it's only one TD is there. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to close this TD. And we need to hold the space of 2 TD. So I'm just going to use call span is equal to 2. The same thing we need to put over there. I'm going to save the page like p1.html. I'm going to save. It's p1.html. I'm going to save on the desktop. Yeah. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to execute this. This is the layout. This is the table layout. The good thing about this layout is if I'm going to minimize this, yeah, still it's working fine. It's completely responsive design without using the bootstrap. because we are using the percentile over there. We are using the percentile over there. So this is the first thing that we need to understand, like how to use the table. So I'm just going to create a table with the width 100%, height 100%, border is 1. Again, I'm going to close the table. How many rows is required? It's 3 rows is required, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to define the TR, 3TR. What will be the height? It's 20%, 20%. Naturally, the remaining 60% will be for the second one. So this is the height we are having, 20%, 20%. And this is the height, 60% for the middle. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to define the TD over there. How many TD is required? So maximum 2 TD is there. So I am just going to give in the middle, its width is equal to 20%. Height is width again is equal to 80%. Now, here we are going to give width 100%, width 100%. We are using call span over there. If I am not going to give the call span, then what? See, what will happen? If I am not going to give the call span, if I am not going to use the call span, run this. Yeah, this is the problem. So we need to use the call span over there. So I am just going to use call span is basically merging the column. That's what is called call span. Call span is equal to 2. Now this is the perfectly fine. So this is how we can design the layout. If we don't have to do anything, if I am not getting anything, what to do? Just use the table, design the layout. This is the first thing that we need to do. Now, the second thing is, the same thing we can also do by the use of div. The same thing we can perform by the use of div also. This is the comment line. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use HTML. HTML. I'm just going to write HTML. HTML, and I'm going to use like head. Close this head over there. And again, I'm going to use the body. I'm going to use the body. Now, if I'm planning for the div, first of all, we need to decide how many div is required. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 div is required. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 div is required. So, I'm just going to define the 4 div over there. So, I'm just going to write div id is equal to 1. And again, I'm going to close this div. So I'm just going to define div id is equal to 1 or id is equal to 2, id is equal to 3, or I'm just going to define id is equal to 4. So 4 div is there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to define the style for that. I'm writing a style. And then I'm going to do what I need to define. We need to define hash 1. This was the ID. So I'm just going to define that. So the left portion will get start from. The left will get start from this corner. So I'm just going to give left is equal to 0 PT. PT means point. Again, I'm going to give top. Top will again start from the 0. Again, I'm going to give the width. Width will be like 100%. Again, I'm going to give the height. Height will be like 100%, 20% of the screen, 20%. And I'm just going to use the background color. Background hyphen color is equal to. Suppose I'm going to give this background color. Now, if I'm going to run this, see, this was the name of the file. It's p1.html. Div id is equal to 1, id is equal to 2, id is equal to background hyphen color, left column 0 pt. Okay, do one thing. I'm just going to use like left. Top width height background hyphen color. Run this. Still we are not getting this. What is the problem? Yeah, semicolon. Yeah, this is the first div we are having. Now what I need to do, again I am going to define the another div over there, has TW2, and again the left will get start from the 0, but the top will get start from 20%. Again I am going to give the width will be 20%. Again I am going to give the height will be like 60%, and background color I am just going to give like green. Remember HTML, CSS, these are not case sensitive, but it will be always better like writing a small. I am just going to give 2, run this. Yeah, it's there. Now what I need to do, this 2, I am just going to use the another one like 3, the left will get start from 20%, the top will the same, width will be it's 80%. Height will be 60%, and background color I am going to give like red. Run this. Yeah, we need to check the spelling. Save this one. Yeah, everything is fine, but we are not getting this thing over here. The problem is we are not using the positioning attribute. So remember, if we are going to use the left, top, width, height and all, always try to use the position. I am just going to give the position. I am just going to give the position. Position absolute. So I am just going to give the position. Absolute means it will fix that. So I am just going to give the position. If I am not going to use the position, then there is no any impact of left, top, width and height. It will create the problem for you. So always give the position. Now run this. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Now what I need to do, I need to define the div in the bottom also. So the bottom div will be like more or less like the upper div. So I am just going to make it copy, and I am just make it like it's a 4. So I am just going to give 4. Left will be the same. The top will be, it will be start from 81%. It will be start from 80%. Width will be 100 and height will be 100. Background color and everything will be the same. Run this. Yeah. So this is how we can design the layout. This is how we can design the layout of the page. So this is the first thing that we need to do. This is the first thing that we need to do. What we need to do? We need to design the page like this. Now, so we are having 1, 2, 3. So these are the 4 div we are having. These are the having 4 div we are having. And accordingly we can do this. So this is the first thing that we need to remember. Like if I want to design the layout and all, either we can use the div or we can use the table.